Next up, we have Raza Hamza. He is 16-0, and he is going great guns at the minute. He's on the verge of a title shot, and he's going to be great to have on this card. I'm going to throw you back over to our commentary team, Dan Murray and Stephen Swifty Smith. Let's go, baby.
Okay, so here we have it, bout number four, Raza Hamza from Birmingham. Been on the scene quite a while now, against Darwin Martinez. I said Russell, he's been on the scene for quite a while now. Feel like he's looking for an opportunity now. He's 30 years old. He's had the 17 fight, so I think he's looking for an opportunity now. Quite a stylish boxer. Nice jab.
Good height, uses reach well. And as you say, he's been on the scene for a while now. He's got an opportunity, definitely.
Martinez comes with a losing record, but looks quite compact, looks quite strong, well schooled. Raza's got to stay switched on, but I think it could be a perfect test, and it could be a good opportunity to get some rounds in before that opportunity comes around for him.
Definitely so, yeah. I think you can see with the way he's shaping up, Raza, he's really switched on here. He's staying compact himself, because he might have felt the weight behind the backhand in the first shot.
When you approach a fight like Stephen, obviously you get in the ring, you don't know much about your opponent. Obviously the first round's a scouting mission, you've got to be very switched on, but obviously as well as it's a short fight, it's a four round fight, you've not got the rounds to kind of warm yourself into it, so you've still got to win the rounds, but you've got to be careful as well.
Definitely, I mean I prefer to start quick. I used to always like to start fast, and I think you're always sort of better building on the lead than trying to chase from behind.
There's a cross shot there, yeah, lovely. There's just a counter right.
But as I say, you don't really have the time in the early fights to start slow and do a bit of a scouting mission, so you've got to sort of get the ground running, but stay switched on in the process. I think Raz has done that really well here. He's been really switched on and come back, but he's well aware of what's coming back at him.
Yeah, fantastic start. Very well disciplined from Raz. Like you say, he's sharp, he's tight, he's picking his shots nice. How important is it for an opponent like Martinez, obviously quite strongest, to get the respect early on? Is it the difference between like an easy night's work and a hard night's work?
I think someone like Martinez knows if if he gets your respect early with his partner, it's a different night. I think if he doesn't to let you feel something, then he's in for a rough, tough night. So I think he's let his power go early, and I think he's got Raz's respect already. Definitely heavy-handed.
Good start from Raza. So the question is, Stephen, from a sort of technical point of view, you're the corner man, what instructions are you giving Raza at this time?
Just sort of what we were touched on in the commentary then, by saying you've got to stay switched on, this kick and punch, he'll know that himself.
More solid jab and
develop it a bit, just like I say, mix your jab up, do a bit of a speed jab, then a bit of thud behind it.
Yeah.
Well, you've got that height, you may as well develop a really good jab, and at the minute I think he's poking it out a lot. See, he's done a better jab then as I spoke, but a lot of his jabs are sort of just throwaway jabs to try and open something up, but you can mix them up, a couple of throwaway ones and a couple of really thudding jabs, and make your opponent not know what's coming.
Yeah. Also produce openings.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. There's nothing worse, and you know, you're giving height away, a kid's taller than you, and then all of a sudden he throws a jab, and it's a hateful jab. It's a pain for a lot of opponents.
Looking to target the body as well.
Yeah.
Sometimes think with these overseas fighters are quite strong and tough. You've got to go down to the body, see how much you actually really want it.
Definitely.
Seven stoppages with Raza, so wouldn't suggest he's a massive puncher, but certainly punches with a bit of authority.
Yeah, and he's maturing as well, he's developing, so you know, power comes, you know, with age and your body sets a bit. I wouldn't write his power off, but it will come. The more he develops and corrects the technique a little bit more, he will get more power. You can see the shot he's throwing here, where he's slipping off the line, letting his right hand go. He's a very classy kid. He's gonna keep improving and getting better. And you know, when he matures, his power will improve as well.
So, for what you've seen so far, Stephen, do you think he's ready to step up, Raza?
Yeah, I think he's obviously had he's had a good number of learning fights. You know, he's 17 fights in now. He's had the one draw early on, but he's unbeaten 17 fights. So, be 18 after tonight, all going well, that's more than enough to be ready, I think. And what he's showing, he looks to me like he's ready for a title of some sort.
Very important he keeps that jab going. We talk about the jab, but he needs to keep it going, because otherwise Martin is just going to march forward and make it a horrible night's work. Thank you. So in a fight like this, Stephen, how important does a cornerman play a role to keep kind of reined in and tell you when to kind of step it up and when to obviously stay disciplined?
Yeah, a good cornerman is very important to all boxers at every level, but a lot can be said more so about when you're on your journey up, you know, sort of helping you learn on the job by seeing things that you're not seeing.
Yeah.
You know, a good seasoned pro will know what's going on in most fights and sort of won't need as much help, but will need little bits, whereas a prospect coming through will need a lot of help and need talking through fights sometimes. Yeah. And you know, your cornerman sees you first hand more than anyone else, and he'll be shouting instructions throughout the round, but we'll have that minute to really change the tactics in a fight.
And I suppose we've had a couple of debutants this evening, and I see that one of them, Ricky Gorman's managed by your Paul.
Yeah.
And obviously Paul knows his boxing, everyone knows he knows his boxing. I suppose that's so important, having a team behind you that knows the game so well, so they can bring you through, they can give you the right challenges at the right time.
Definitely. You can be inexperienced, obviously, you know, a debutant, you've got no experience behind you, might have a big or short or long amateur career, but it doesn't really matter too much in terms of the pro game. You're still as inexperienced as anyone else on the debut, but having a good team behind you does give you that experience. You know, yeah. Me and my brothers used to always say it, although we hadn't been in title fights at the time, we all felt like we've been through it before because we've been there with my brothers, and any experience is good experience, really.
Yeah.
Looking for the backhand, this opponent, and you can hear the noise off him. He's definitely got a bit of pop behind it.
Yeah, it's such a difference when Raza uses a jab, because it just puts him off balance a little bit, breaks the picture up. When he doesn't jab, Martinez walks forward and he starts letting his shots go.
That jab can keep it at Raza's range and start instead of letting the kick get to his range. Obviously he's shorter, he needs to get close to land a shot, so yeah. You know, if you can keep him at bay with a jab, then you know, do it all you can.
Yeah.
For the points of offer.
Just feel like it's getting to the stage of the fight where Raza needs to land something to maybe get some respect.
Yeah. He's trying all the rough out tactics, and he feels like going through by the referee, obviously by the cornerman, helping and stuff. And he's going to keep trying to keep coming. So I think it'd be now be a good time for Raza to land some clean shots, get the respect back, and then go the way.
Disciplined performance from Raza so far, I think it's fair to say.
Yeah, I like the start of this round, but I'm assuming he's been told in his corner to go out and sort of mixes jab up, feinting jab, and he's keeping his opponent guessing by doing that. Like, you know, the feints are a really good weapon in your arsenal to have, and he keeps doing it now at the start of this round. He's mixed it up a lot. Shots a lot, and you find a fake works a lot better with someone who's loading up, because you're looking for that one trigger to get the big shot off. So by faking them and keeping them guessing, it's going to keep them on toes all night.
Yeah. So he's loading up, he's obviously coming forward, Martinez. If you're in there, Stephen, are you looking to set traps? Are you looking to walk onto a shot?
Exactly that, but just doing what Raz has done to start this round, just feinting, mixing the jab up, so you know you're keeping the range where you want it, but the feint are keeping him, offsetting him, just don't let him stand, get his feet in, load up and throw the bomb. If you're offsetting him all the time with feints and jabs, then you're not letting him really set himself where he wants to be for the big power shot, and then in between you can get your own shots off.
The maiden promotion for Vinco Boxing here, Stephen. The production's next level. It's absolutely brilliant, and had a really good turnout as well.
Yeah, it has. It's been a really good start.
And also a very, very good card as well. Good top of the bill. WBO European title fight, British title eliminator. But all the fights have been interesting on the way through.
Yeah, it's been a good night's boxing up to now, and as you say, the best yet to come. With a really competitive fight, top the evening off.
As a fighter fighting for a new promoter, do you feel an extra pressure to put on a good performance?
It depends massively on what stage of your career you're at. If you're an experienced pro, it's just about going and getting the job done. It doesn't really matter to you what promotion it's on. If you're a young novice pro, then massively so. You want them to go out and impress, because you want them back on your show again.
Yeah.
You want them to think, I want that kid back. You want them to sell tickets. You want them to do everything well. So you're probably trying more to impress. Whereas when it's later on in your career, you just, the win's all that matters to you.
So your career, it feels like not long ago you announced your retirement.
Yeah.
Reflecting on your career, what's the high point of it?
To be honest with you, I enjoyed my career, amateur and pro. The amateur was winning the Commonwealth Games. I loved it, with it being in Australia as well, beside the world. As a professional, probably when I won my second British title against Gary Buckland in Cardiff, it was a special night for me, just because it was my son's first birthday. So my firstborn son, it was his first birthday. So I wanted to fight, because I just never believed I'd lose that day, and it rang true for me.
Am I right in thinking of a thing about Gary Buckland at the time was on a bit of a roll?
He was on a rich vein of form, he was on a good run of wins, and he had stopped his last three, like Paul Crushcott, Stephen Bell, good fighters, and coming into the fight, I just had a supreme belief in myself that A, I'd win the fight, I'd be a two-time British champion, I thought he was the better fighter, but B, I wouldn't lose on my son's first birthday. Didn't see it written in the stars for myself, and got in there with the confidence, as I say, as an underdog. It was a 4-1 underdog, and I come away with the title, which was a special night for me. And I don't bring my kids to the boxing, but I brought my son down that night and left him in the hotel, just sort of spend the day with him, and it'll be a memory I'll keep forever.
Am I right in thinking you stopped Buck on that night?
Yeah, knocked him out in the fifth.
Any regrets with your career?
Not so much. No, I had bits of bad luck here and there, but nothing I could have changed. I gave everything I had. I trained as hard as I could train, and I went through in every fight I had. So it's difficult to go back and do it again. In hindsight, I do things a little bit different, you know, with the knowledge I've got now, and maybe sometimes tactically I'd adjust certain fights, but everything's easy in hindsight when you look back. So I don't think it had gone through, I could have been much better than what it did.
We had a fantastic amateur and pro career. Hopefully at some point you kind of get back in and pass that knowledge on to people.
Yeah, I've really enjoyed that. I think one day I'll get back involved in the coaching, but I just want to be able to commit all my time to it.
Yeah. I'm watching your brother's fight. Is it more nerve-wracking than when you fight?
Yeah, way more. I don't enjoy watching my brother's box, but you know, they're having a fantastic success.
Oh yeah.
You know, I've been really, really proud and privileged to be a part of it, you know, fighting family, but it doesn't get any easier watching.
I mean, Liam just seems to be going from strength to strength. He seems to be getting better with age.
Yeah, he's defying all knowledge. He's just getting better as he gets older.
Yeah. Just back to the action in the ring. Hamza obviously doing what he needs to do, but obviously Martin is still coming forward strong.
He's so game and skinny. He's definitely got heavy hands and he doesn't believe he's out this fight. He's still going for it and throwing bombs, but he won't do that as no harm as long as he stays switched on and comes through.
Yeah, I agree. You think these rounds are valuable. It's a six round fight, but you could watch this over 8 or 10 rounds and I think it would do Russell very, very good.
They say in boxing, like they say in journeyman, gets used a lot and you get people turning for wages and stuff, but this kid's certainly no journeyman, mate. He's come here and he's through everything at Raza.
Yeah, because I often think of an opponent like this, if you don't turn up with your A game, if you're not 100%, you could quite easily come out with a loss.
You can see 90% of this kid's right hand, he's through, he's tried to take his head off.
Of course, as well, sometimes you see him at small shows, the small hall shows, you see the journeymen come and they just kind of go on the back foot and survive. And then you'll have a prospect, you'll have 10 or 12 of them, and then when he steps up against someone who comes to fight, it's just a massive gulf in class, and it almost like a rabbit in the headlights.
Definitely. I think too many negative fights can do you more harm than good.
Yeah.
You get used to throwing punches and not coming back, you may as well go on the bags in the gym. Whereas you get an opponent like this fella tonight and starts throwing, you know, everything and every shot at you, then you will come unstuck if you haven't put the groundwork in, as in, you know, you haven't fought the right opponent. So it's been really well matched this fight tonight, and I think it'll do Raza really, really good in the future.
Yeah. So last round of the contest. I mean, if you're in there, Stephen, are you looking to close the show in style, or are you just looking to obviously take the points win?
I'd always try and finish it, but I wouldn't be going reckless. You know, he's been in this fight, so if he was to go out and get reckless and get chinned, he'd never forgive himself. So you've always got to stay switched on, and you know, there's a job to do, so do your job by getting the win. But if you see the openings, then me and myself, I'd always go for it.
Yeah.
I think he's doing the right thing here. He's turning the screw, but he's not going now for leather. You know, he's still backing him up. He's still looking for openings, but he's not going gung-ho. He doesn't need to.
I agree with you what you're saying earlier about he should try and step up now. I think this fight so far has shown that he's ready for that step up. This is the sort of fight, if he wasn't ready, like I said, you end up with a loss of the record.
Indeed. I think the opponent's trying to sucker him in now. He's trying to land the one bomb because he sees that as a runaway victory now.
Is there anything that's particularly impressed you with Raza tonight?
I think he's kept his composure really well. I think, you know, he's had big shots coming back at him and he's let some big shots go himself, but he's done that really well a few times tonight. The slip right hand, he can get that shot off good and he uses his height well with it, but I think overall it's staying composed because he's been caught tonight, but he hasn't thought to let lose composure. So I think that's been a big box tick for him. And again, he's had the little flashes of skill where he's done the split right hands, which shows you he's been working on things in the gym.
I think I probably agree with you with the jab as well, the observation you made earlier on that when he's used it, he's had success and it's shown. But like you say, a bit of variety in the jab, maybe strengthen it up at times.
You can see his favourite shot, the right hand. He loves it, the slip right hand. And the amount of times he throws the jab away just looking for the right hand.
Yeah.
It's not really good for someone of his height. Someone of his height, if I was to fight someone that would fall on me and he weren't really landing the jab with authority, I'd be buzzing.
Yeah.
Whereas if I'm with him with a tall kid and he's really thudding that jab home, I'm thinking, oh, it's going to be a long night.
I suppose he's going to need that jab if he steps up the levels as well, isn't he?
Throwing big shots and he had to talk up and be smart.
Sometimes you've got to watch out, haven't you? Like, you can't slip up even if the record isn't as good as yours or your previous opponent or whatever. You cannot switch off in this game for a second, can you?
Listen, this is boxing and, you know, it only takes one shot and that. And I've been that person that's been hit with that shot by Ovanov. So, yeah, you've got to stay switched on at all times.
Never give up. Never give in, even when you think you can't take anymore. Never give up, never give in, just remember what it is you're fighting for. It's a long